Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Carver Hawkeye Arena for this afternoon's Big Ten matchup between the Michigan Wolverines and the University of Iowa Hawkeyes. Now let's meet the starting lineups. For Michigan, starting at one forward, a 6'6 senior from Lake Bluff, Illinois, number 3, Rob Palinka. For Iowa at one forward, Wade Lookingbill, a 6'5 senior from Fort Dodge. Starting at the other forward for Michigan, a 6'9 sophomore from Detroit, Michigan, number 4, Chris Weber. For Iowa at the other forward, a 6'5 junior from Joliet, Illinois, number 23, James Winters. Center for Michigan, a 6'9 sophomore from Chicago, Illinois, number 25, Jawan Howard. And at center for Iowa, a 6'10 senior from Moline, Illinois, number 55, A.C. Earl. Starting at one guard for the Wolverines, a 6'5 sophomore from Plano, Texas, number 24, Jimmy King. At one guard for the Hawkeyes, a 5'11 junior from Fort Worth, Texas, number 10, Kevin Smith. At the other guard for Michigan, a 6'8 sophomore from Detroit, Michigan, number 5, Jalen Rose. And starting at the other guard for the Hawkeyes, a 6'2 senior from Wichita, Kansas, number 20, Val Barnes. And introducing the coaches for Michigan in his fourth full season, Steve Fisher, assisted by Brian Dutcher, Perry Watson, and Jay Smith. And introducing the coach of the Hawkeyes in his seventh season at Iowa, Tom Davis, assisted by Gary Close, Rick Moss, and Rich Walker.
All right, Bob Holzhammer with the introductions. Fifth-ranked Michigan, 11th-ranked Iowa, coming up next. Indiana is unbeaten in the Big Ten. Michigan's only loss to the Hoosiers, 1-point loss at that. Illinois, Wisconsin, Iowa fifth, and the rest of the Big Ten. The officials today, Jim Burr from Albany, New York, Ed Hightower from Alton, Illinois, and Tim Higgins from Ramsey, New Jersey. Chris Weber with that protective mask in the middle with A.C. Earl, and Earl tips it back to Smith. Barnes in the corner, here's Iowa.
Great man, Jim. It's not often that Weber does not get the tip. A.C. Earl has position on him. Again, positioned by A.C. Earl.
Earl walked.
And what we're seeing, Jim, is doubling down from the weak side, that time by Rose. So they're going to let Earl touch the ball and then from the weak side come down and double team him.
Jalen Rose controlling. He had his 20th birthday yesterday and returns to the side of his career high 34 set last January here.
How about Jawan Howard being the man that helps bring the ball up the court? Really a gifted big man, skilled in all areas.
Jimmy King, almost a set shot, a 3-pointer for King to open the scoring. Earl at the other end, rejected by Weber. Here comes Michigan on the break. King with the ball. He was their top 3 shooter last year. Howard jumper, 5-0 Michigan.
He really gets the ball up above his head beautifully on that short jump shot. Understands his range, always takes good shots.
Winters driving past Howard and outside Howard on the hold.
Jim, you remember this Michigan team last year. Ray Jackson was their defensive stopper. And now you've got Jimmy King, who's developed into an outstanding defender. And then you have Howard, who's as good a low post defender in college basketball. So that gives them 3 outstanding defenders.
Steve Fisher told us that King has quietly become our best defensive stopper. King is guarding Barnes at the moment. Inside is Earl.
There's that double team again.
Open is Smith. Not usually a good outside shooter. He missed that one.
That's one of the reasons why that weak side double team is so effective, because they don't care if it goes back out to Smith for the jump shot.
Smith coming off a season high against Michigan State where he had 11. And here he gets the rebound and takes it up the middle. Driving Smith. Beautiful move, but he missed the shot. Howard.
What a dribble.
And a turnaround move by Juwan Howard, taking it the length of the court.
Well, Jim, we watched him in practice, and you and I both feel he's as hard a working guy on the basic fundamentals as any big guy we've seen in college basketball. And there's why his game is progressing to such a high level.
Fisher says he's our toughest competitor, and he really does work to improve himself every minute in practice. Barnes missing a three. Iowa still has not scored. 2 minutes, 20 seconds into the game.
We talked about Jim's skilled positions being too high up for a game, and I think that's what's happening to Iowa right now. They need to go down low to AC Earl a while.
On the baseline, Rose had to alter his shot. Weber flips it in, though. 9-0 Michigan.
Right now, you got to get that ball down inside to AC Earl. Go ahead and let him double team, dish back out, try to get Val Barnes in a situation where he's got the jump shot.
Earl wants the shot. Earl gets Iowa on the scoreboard.
That's the man.
Earl averaging 16 points, had 27, and then a career-high 16 rebounds in the victory over the Spartans on Thursday.
He had 13 rebounds a number of times, but that breaks his all-time high.
And there's a block. Iowa's all-time shot blocker, A.C. Earl. Number 322 on his career.
Smart play by Winters that time, not to try to advance the ball with the dribble. Back screen looking for the lob for Winters, not there.
Barnes slicing and scoring.
Jim, there was a curl move that Jalen Rose, despite the fact that Michigan worked on that all day yesterday in practice on their defensive assignments, Jalen just didn't beat Val Barnes to the spot. Lazy getting there. Oh, what hands.
Blocked by Earl. His second rejection and a whistle before the shot. They call a foul, I believe, on Earl. First, he picked up his second block of the game.
Well, Jim, the defender of the year last year in the Big Ten, probably will be right up there again this year. Back-to-back years, he broke his own Iowa records for shot blocking and moving up on the national list.
Earl sits, two players in for Iowa, number 42, Jay Webb, and 52, Russ Millard. Juwan Howard now with six.
Now Millard got a piece of that. Howard just too strong, ripped the ball away from him.
Barnes, that's a three-pointer. 11-7 Michigan.
Really important for Iowa to get Barnes off in the first half. He's been brilliant in second halves of games. Here's the press trying to force it down one side, but Howard, of course, being the trailer, good safety valve.
Weber. Olinka tried to save it, had the foot on the line. Iowa basketball. Well, Michigan raced out to a 9-0 lead. Iowa has scored seven of the last nine, so it's 11-7 Michigan. Billy, as we digest these numbers with this season's numbers on the right for Michigan, you can see they've improved in a lot of areas.
Well, Jim, a much better basketball team. The thing that really impressed you, with the exception of Indiana having a 55% shooting game against these guys, in the last eight games, they've held opponents to 41%.
Webb with a nice shot. The pressure, Howard able to get it in. Other than Indiana shooting 55% from the floor, the next best was 47% against Michigan all year.
Exactly. Nice
Weber.
Dump.
Right back to Weber. Forget about it.
And climbs right over Millard. Has the presence of mind to make that catch in traffic and then do the step right on over without walking. He's quite a player.
Montier Glasper in for Iowa, number 13, and Kenyon Murray, number 3, who gets it into Millard.
Jim Millard's quite a story. You know, he comes in the last game, not expected to play much all year, and has 5 points, 4 rebounds, and just a short period of time against Michigan State. Could become a key player.
That was his first action of his career at Iowa, redshirted last year. Ray Jackson in for the Fab Five. And a kick. Michigan will inbound.
Watch Weber. Steps right over. Gets his composed feeling. Goes up with the stuff. Brilliant play.
A.C. Earl back in. He's on Rose. Now a switch off. Rose up. Oh, that's going to be goaltending.
Well, no question about the call, but it shows you the timing by A.C. Earl. He just was too far under the basket when he went up on this one, but it catches it right on the way as it starts down. Great timing. Long arms. There's that back screen, and Earl puts it on the floor. And it almost looks like he's uncoordinated when he does that, but he has the ability to keep that ball in his possession.
That was off of Rose. Iowa with two freshmen on the floor right now. Actually, three freshmen. Two freshmen. They've taken Millard out. Here's Glasper. He's one of them. And the other freshman is Kenyon Murray, who is now with the basketball right there.
And a former Mr. Basketball of Michigan, so a little emotion for him here today.
Earl not even close on the baseline turnaround. Iowa had hit its last five from the floor before that one.
And see how Tom Davis has moved his press up a little bit further. Now what Michigan's going to try to do is to throw over the front line of the Iowa press. They've got the size with Rose back there to do it. Now Riley in the game gives him another big target.
So Weber out, Riley in, and back in now for Iowa is Winters, joined by Jim Bartles, who's getting his first playing time.
Here we go into the zone with Winters playing on top, and he drops all the way down inside.
Jackson nails the three. Now they call it a two. They rule it a two.
Jackson wanting to get back into that starting lineup, playing very aggressive basketball since he came back from that injury.
Jackson
missed.
There's
a switch. Somebody's wide open.
About to say that Jackson missed 7 games because of a dislocated shoulder. Do you think it's just a matter of time before they work him back in?
I would think so, Jim. He gives them so much defensively. He's a very aggressive basketball player, and that became a unit that was hard to handle last year at the end of the season. I would anticipate that five will get back together again shortly.
Looking Bill in, and he's inbounding for Iowa. Winters right underneath. Pump fake. And the rebound to Rose. Oh, way too high. Off the glass. Bartles has it.
Jalen might have thought that Chris Weber was still in the game. He threw it up there where Weber can grab it. Riley not as quick off his feet.
They had to stop the action to fix the net at the Iowa end. And some people a little upset. They thought the Hawkeyes had a break opportunity.
And if they had missed the basket, they'd say, why didn't you stop the game and let the net come down? So you can't win if you're a ref sometimes.
But it was the right call.
There's that double team from the weak side again.
Looking Bill, three-pointer off the back of the rim. King settles down in the backcourt. He'll bring it up.
And here you see the 1-2-2 zone. Winners up top.
Riley had position, did a great job of backing in on Looking Bill.
Well, Jim, what happened to Looking Bill? He was so low down on the blocks. He has got the front, Riley, in that situation. Oh, there's a solid
screen. Rose just took out Looking Bill.
Now, you know, I really don't agree with that call, Jim, unless they're calling it on Looking Bill.
They are calling it on Looking Bill.
I'll tell you why. Looking Bill was not planted, and Rose has the right to be moving. The fact that Rose knocked Looking Bill down does not mean that's a foul. Now, watch this right here.
But is it a foul the other way?
No, I think it's a foul on Looking Bill. He was not planted to set the solid screen. He's the one that created the contact. Rose was already moving. He has the right. Jody's a little stronger than we think. He put Looking Bill right in his back.
Smith off the deflection
Barnes
by
open.
Earl. Smith takes it, had the right spin on it. 19-13, Michigan.
There again, they're throwing over the top of the press. Tom Davis is going to recognize that and change some things.
Well, there's a turnover. And a break in the action with the Wolverines leading by six. It almost appeared to me, Billy, that Lookingbill was going to slide right by Rose and hardly make contact. I thought maybe it was going to be a no call.
Well, then Rose did a good job by making sure there was contact. Nice job by Riley on the inside.
Michigan with the six-point lead. Tally in. Michael Tally now in for the first time. Number 14 for Michigan.
And the 2-3 zone stays, and there's that same attack.
Winters stripped it away. Barnes, three-pointer. Weber was hacked by Winters when he went up for the rebound. Millard back in along with Murray. Webb and Winters sit.
Jim, Winters going down. He had 18 rebounds in a ball game against American U to give you an idea of how he can get up on the boards. Very strong. Here's that 1-2, 1-1 full court pressure. Go ahead.
Wolverines with a rebounding edge right now of 10-2.
Tally into the game. He's had big games against Iowa in his career.
Riley with a nice touch. He's their top free throw shooter, also the 7-footer. Smooth on that one.
And Murray down low. They double team. Good pass, weak side.
Millard got it in to Earl. And the foul against Michigan. Against Ray Jackson. Next Saturday on CBS, Florida State and UConn. 2 o'clock Eastern time. And that'll be followed by the AT&T Pebble Beach National Pro-Am premiere. Our golf coverage on CBS 93 style. From really my favorite spot in the whole world, Pebble Beach.
Well, Jim, you know, you see that Florida State situation. They were part of that back-to-back nights this week when Florida State had that loss against North Carolina in a game that they had salted away.
21-point lead in that game, second half.
And Michigan State, of course, had Iowa to the point that you'd never believe Iowa could come back in that game and win. A part of the changing focus in college basketball, and one in which I think the semi-delay game is going to have to become an important part of coaching philosophy, the way teams shoot that three and occupy the 45-second shot clock.
Iowa somehow scored 21 points in the last 3 minutes of regulation to get that game to overtime. Tally. Underneath Earl, he had a player on his back. They call it on Weber.
Now, Jim, remember at the start of the show, we talked about telestrating the way Iowa gets a triangle on the basket to rebound. Here is a perfect example. Watch the blocking out. Millard puts a body on Weber. Doesn't allow him to get inside. And there's A.C. Earl picking off the rebound, but Michigan had no way to get inside position. Good technique, great coaching there by Tom Davis.
Right here, good looking prospect for Iowa.
Asked to move out of the starting lineup, said he feels more comfortable coming in as a reserve.
And he hits the two as we're talking about him. Cuts it to five, 21-16 Michigan. Riley. Over the back, it's going to be on Weber.
Again, defensive positioning on the boards by Iowa. Weber has to go over the back because Iowa's got everything covered inside.
Second on Weber, the fifth team foul against Michigan.
Jim, one of the things, if I were Iowa, that I would do, I would feed the post, being A.C. Earl, with Smith, who's not their best outside shooter. Because what's happening, they're feeding the post with their best outside shooter. Therefore, the double team's taking place. They're not worried about Smith. Let Smith pass the ball down low.
Murray from almost the same spot he hit a minute ago. Rose with the long outlet. Weber trailing. Murray gets back for the rebound, and Jackson bumped him. That'll be the sixth team foul and the second against Ray Jackson.
That was a well-executed fast break by Michigan, and Weber almost pulled off a sensational move with the ball.
Put it on his hip for just a second.
Right. Great transition defense by Iowa getting back, eliminating the fast break.
Rob Pelinka has come in from Michigan. Weber sits. Palinka, this is his second Big Ten start. He had his first earlier in the week against Ohio State and responded with 16 points. Millard can't handle it. Murray gets it, and a whistle underneath. Another Michigan foul. They picked up a bunch in a quick span here. That's against Talley, and they'll shoot a 1-1.
Jim, what we're seeing right now, I think, is Iowa's starting to calm down a little bit from that emotion they started this game with, starting to get a lot better shots on the inside. And I think their substitution pattern now is starting to work out a little better.
1-1. In the Big Ten, Iowa the best free throw shooting team, and Michigan 11th. Out of the 11.
Shooting almost 71%, and they go to the line. They're kind of like the Dukes of this world. They've had 358 made, and their opponent had only been to the line 225 times. It's an important part of their offense.
Lead has been trimmed to 3. Iowa very scrappy, but unable to force the turnover on that series.
And here they're still in that 1-2-2 zone. Talley out on top. He needs to hit a shot. Talley's going to be open, out on top.
He finds Palinka open, way too long. Riley with the rebound and a foul against AC Earl. Put Riley on the line for 2. He's their, again, best free throw shooter. For Earl, that's his second 15 foul.
You know, Jim, what's kind of crazy, and we just think back of that Duke-Iowa game. Iowa only went to the foul line 5 times against Duke, a team that, you know, the way they play, it's hard to believe. Important for them to start getting some baskets a little bit easier than what they're taking so far.
Steve Fisher told us yesterday about Riley. I've got to find him more time. He's been cheated out of minutes, and it's my fault.
It was interesting in talking to him and to his assistant coaches, talking about playing Riley and Howard and Weber at the same time may be an answer. But Steve Fisher doesn't think so.
Howard missed in the lane. Murray from the corner.
2 straight jumpers.
It's a 2-point game, 22-20 Michigan. Rose had to just save it right in front of us. Iowa now with a chance to tie it. Lasper has it blocked, but he gets it back.
That wasn't the shot that Tom Davis wanted. Getting a lot done during the time they're resting AC Earl here, Jim. Where are the points going to come from? Kenyon Murray, he's the only one who's been able to put it up out of this group.
Bartles in the game can shoot the long-range 3, but unable to get open at the
solid
moment.
Screen. There's Murray.
That's a 3 for the lead, and a foul on the play. Chance for the rare 4-point play.
And Jim Murray talked about the players from Michigan State giving him a lot of lip in that ball game just this week about leaving the state of Michigan. Now with his parents here today, he is playing very well against a team that he almost became a teammate of.
From Battle Creek, Michigan, Kenyon Murray. Jackson and King, the two Texans, back in for the Wolverines. Palinka and Talley go out. Murray, kind of interesting, Billy, when we visited with him, he said he visited with Michigan and then signed with Iowa the very next day.
Well, you know, let's be honest. If you're a player of his magnitude and you take a look at 5 freshmen that are starting and you say, hey, I'd like to have some playing time right off the bat.
But that visit would have been in November of 91,
yep.
Right about the time when they were just practicing at Michigan. We didn't know exactly what kind of impact the Fab Five would have on college basketball.
Right. I think high school players have a better idea than we do sometimes about talent.
Jackson kind of cleared out on the way up. I thought they might call it against him, but instead Webb gets the whistle. His second.
Well, Ray Jackson's pants belie the fact that he is a Skywalker. I mean, it looks like he's got a load in him, you know, when he walks around there. But he gets off the ground as well as anybody on this Michigan team. Great vertical leap and almost flushed that last one.
Pat O'Brien coming up with Prudential Securities at the half with a tribute
to Chris Street. on Pat's Hoop du Jour show, they ought to see who has the longest pants in college basketball. Jackson would be in the running.
Check out Jalen Rose in practice. He's pretty close, too. Michigan with the one-point lead. Well, Michigan exploded to a 9-0 lead, but field goal percentage is pretty high. In fact, look at Michigan, 50%, and Iowa allows only 38% on the season.
Right, and Iowa shooting 47%. We talked about how well Michigan is doing, holding people down in the 41 percentile, with the exception of their Big Ten game against Indiana. So, team shooting a little better than expected. Michigan straight man-to-man the whole game. Iowa showing various defenses.
Millard on Weber.
Jim, I like him. He's powerful inside.
Winners missed the easy one. Back to Barnes. He'll use the glass.
That was Millard that kept it alive.
Millard didn't look intimidated at all, making a move
on
Weber. Rose to Jackson.
Nice job by Jalen Rose. Smart play the way he dished that off.
Ray Jackson with six.
Pretty good hands by Winners.
Barnes, he likes this one. Tried to save it, but to no avail.
Barnes, a pretty good rebounder, Jim, from the guard position. Good nose for the ball following his shot after misses.
Weber showing a lot of patience on that.
Yep. I don't think...
And he gets it eventually.
Now, Jim, what happened is that Iowa didn't recognize the defense they're in. Millard didn't realize he was supposed to be the man out front. So Michigan wisely took their time, got in good position, and really hit an easy two.
Weber has six. And a reach in by Jackson. That'll be number three against Ray Jackson. Be a 1-1 for Iowa.
Here was the 1-2-2 zone, but what happened? Millard wasn't sure of his position in the zone, and when he went out front, Michigan attacked from the backside. Very smart playing by the Michigan club. Here's Boskelin for the first time, Jim.
He has started some games recently during Jackson's absence.
Had some tendonitis problems with his knee. We'll all remember how well he played last year in the Final Four. Really was the catalyst to get Michigan back on track in that Cincinnati game.
Yeah, he came off the bench against the Bearcats with 9 points and 4 rebounds.
Hey, and talking, I saw your picks the other day.
Uh-oh.
You've got the same Final Four back again next year.
Hey.
I'll tell you, that Cincinnati club, they are doing it on both ends of the floor.
Everyone wants to overlook them, even still. And when the new poll is released tomorrow, look and see now how last year's Final Four is in the top six. They've found their way back. Weber on the follow.
There was one of the few times you didn't find Iowa properly blocking out from the weak side. Chris Weber left unattended. Doesn't happen often.
30-27 Wolverines.
See, again, Iowa keeps trying to feed down to A.C. Earl with Barnes on the same side of the court. They're doubling down on A.C. Earl. Barnes should be on the other side of the floor, so A.C. could just flip it back out to him for an easy jump shot.
Webb and Smith in for Millard and Glasper.
When you know you're going to be double-teamed from the weak side, A.C. Earl should just catch that ball and fire opposite, but they've got to have their best shooter opposite. Good defense by Juwan Howard on A.C. Earl. Just wouldn't go for any fakes.
Earl, 8-footer. Earl with five, and Iowa within one.
As I said, uncoordinated, but there was a great change off the pass. Not a good shot by Jaylen.
Up ahead. Winners can give him the lead. And a steal by Smith. Barnes passes up. What a shot. Doesn't fall. Howard with the rebound.
Jalen Rose, when he drives to the inside, Jimmy King's got to get back for defensive balance.
Rose, he's been off this year on his three.
He's going to stay off because he doesn't work at it.
And a travel gives the ball back to the Wolverines. Rose only 24%, Billy, from three-point land.
Well, he'd be the kind of guy you'd want to tape in practice and let him see his own tape, because he never works hard on his three-point shooting under game conditions. And therefore, when the game comes and he's speeding up, it's just not there to be made. He's a gifted player, but the work ethic and practice, and particularly on that particular skill, is not there.
Riley in, Weber out. For that matter, Rose's scoring average is down a couple this year, averaging 15.5 a game. But Steve Fisher says he's our leader.
Here you see that defense again, changing up a little bit.
Bosco.
Jay Webb out front makes a tough target to shoot over.
King goes to the other side. Good move by Jimmy King.
Wisely used the rim to shield off the defenders.
Smith. Oh, yes. Kevin Smith gives Iowa the lead back. 4:20 left in the half. Rose, plus one.
Oh, and he counts it. At 6'8", Jim, there's what he does so well. He just goes over the top of guards, and he glides through the air. Jim, just glide right through the air. No opportunity for Smith to handle him. Smith at about 5'10". Jaylen just goes at 6'8", goes right over the top.
44 Bartles in, and A.C. Earl back also with the two fouls.
And Jim, you talked about Jaylen. Jaylen this year from the three-point line is now 10 for 42. So you're down, under 25%. Not good at all.
Iowa number 11, Kevin Skillett with his first action. Three-point play for Rose. Now with 5 points. Murray gives it up inside to Earl. Makes the move, gets the foul, almost got it to drop. He'll shoot two. A.C. Earl, first team All Big Ten in 92. I didn't even realize it. Not one player off of Michigan made first team Big Ten last year. They made it all the way to the Final Four.
Jaylen and Chris Webber both made it second team. Of course, Chris was first team all-conference preseason this year, along with this young man right here, A.C. Earl.
All-time at Iowa, first in blocks. In fact, he's the leading active shot blocker in college basketball.
I'll tell you what's interesting, Jim. Of course, he's already graduated, but what's interesting, he redshirted his freshman year, not because of anything other than the fact he just didn't play basketball well enough to be a Big Ten player. Now he is one of the best in the league. Hard work, dedication. He's done it both in the classroom and on the court. Made himself what he is today.
And a big career ahead.
Yep.
Looking Bill replaces him. Game is tied with 4:05 left in the half.
Again, Michigan going right over the top of the press.
Bosco with the three. That's the one that he tried against Indiana the game's in. And surprisingly, Weber got the rebound and Henderson rejected it to hold on for victory for the Hoosiers. We will have, by the way, the rematch for those two February the 14th. What could be for the Big Ten title.
Well, this league is so deep this year that you've got to believe somewhere along the line somebody's going to slow down IU other than Michigan. But they have been just knocking teams out of the way. The other thing, Jim, when you take a look at the schedule, Indiana has won a lot of games on the road in the Big Ten.
Back half of their season is stacked at home.
Yeah.
That foul was against Riley, his second. So Millard at the line for two.
I'll handle guys.
Smith comes back in.
I think Millard is going to play some minutes, Jim, before this is over. You know what? We talk about, you know, where is the playing time that Chris Street had, you know, all the minutes that he played so aggressively, and it's got to come off that bench somewhere. I think Millard's one of those guys going to take up some of those minutes.
He was not eligible until the semester break. At 15 minutes of action on Thursday, he'll see a lot of time today. Iowa down one.
Hawkeye Fever here at Carver Hawkeye Arena, Michigan by one, coming up on Prudential Securities at the half. All the sports news, including government versus the referees, controversy in the Big Ten, and the 20th from the last word on Super Bowl 27, a live report from the big game, and a special tribute to Chris Street here at Iowa. And all that's coming up on Prudential Securities at the half. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Pat. And the Chris Street family in attendance today, up from Indianola, 2 hours away.
Here again we see the valuable ability of Howard to be able to handle that ball. He doesn't get it over in 10 seconds. Now, he let the ball release, but it never got into the front court. You've got to catch the ball. Good call. And what you have down there, is the official telling both Steve Fisher and the players from Michigan that the ball must touch somebody in that front court. Really packing things in on AC Earl now. Two good shooters in the game, Barnes and Murray.
Good pass by Earl, but it was stolen out of the hands of Webb. Howard lobs it to Riley. And Earl got a hand on it.
Again, Earl just running the floor.
Smith with a three, pull-up three. Murray had position underneath, but on the outside, the foul over the back on Webb.
Murray extremely quick getting off the floor down on the inside. Likes to play in the open court area.
The third on Webb, so he'll go to the bench. Millard in. And Michigan will shoot a 1-1.
Jim, I think that Smith has got to be a little bit more patient. When, you know, you've got AC Earl down low. Now they can surround that particular defense that's trying to double-team AC Earl with both Barnes and Kenyon Murray. So get Smith over on the side, let him feed, and it gives AC Earl an opportunity to go out in either direction now, and Iowa could be effective by getting it down inside and pumping it out quickly.
1-1. Long rebound to Smith. Barnes jumper. Iowa back in front, 39-38.
He is a scorer.
Murray got an elbow in the face. Unintentional from Bosco.
Now he can get some consultation from Weber on that. That's about the same type of injury he had.
From behind, Earl with the block. Out of bounds belongs to the Wolverines.
And we'll see what happened. So often, you just have your nose in the wrong place at the wrong time. And we talked about Chris Weber getting hit in practice, and then, of course, he comes back the very first game, and the first few minutes gets hit in the same way.
Weber hopes to have the mask off in 1 week. Might have to have it in the Purdue game next Sunday, you'll see here on CBS, but after that they say it'll be clear. Rose gets the three this time, and Riley trying to get position underneath, called for the foul.
You see, yeah, the basket counts. You see how Jalen concentrated on that shot, Jim? He stuck right with it, followed it all the way into the basket. This guy, AC Earl, he is everywhere down in the post, both on the offensive and defensive end of the floor. Has only averaged throughout his career 2 fouls a game.
Weber comes in for Riley, who sits with three.
I'm talking about fouls committed, not fouls on the line. So that's amazing that he plays well within himself.
And he has not fouled out of a game since his freshman year.
Correct.
You asked me that question when we had that game at Duke.
That's right.
Who was the player that never fouled out of a game?
In his career. Will Chamberlain. I'm going to give you one today, all right?
You know how many times my answer there, by the
way, was
Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Yeah.
As Lou Alcindor at UCLA, he fouled out of two games. I had to go back home and look it up.
Oh, you did?
Only two times.
And I'm going to give you one today, okay? And I hate to break up this game. A very important day today.
But you're going
to
do it anyway.
Yeah, I am. One man more important to what we're doing right now and the Super Bowl than any man in the history of sport. And I'm going to tell you what it was.
Wait, it has something to do with this game?
With the basketball that we're watching and today's Super Bowl. You know what it was? Dr. Naismith.
Barnes on the steal, and Iowa takes the two-point lead.
First time they picked one on the inbounds pass.
Rose ties it at the other end. All right, how
about
Naismith?
I'll tell you why. Naismith is the man that basically invented the football helmet. So without him, we don't have basketball. Without him, you don't have football. So who's more important than that? I close my case.
But you started talking about the Super Bowl. That's where you threw me off. Winners makes the move. Over the back is Millard.
Yep.
You talk about Naismith. I'll throw one at you.
Okay.
You know this, though, I'm sure.
I don't know.
The only coach in Kansas history with a losing record.
Dr. James Naismith. I didn't say he could coach. I said he's important to the day today. Yeah, that is our.
He got out of coaching to invent the football helmet. Yeah,
right.
There you go. Millard with the foul, his first. And this is a 1-1. It's only 9 against Iowa. Next one will be the double bonus. Howard's already missed the front end of a 1-1.
Well, Iowa started off, as we said, in a very emotional pitch, down 9-0. They've done a fine job to get back in this one.
That puts Michigan in front. This guy had 20 rebounds in a game against Wisconsin this season.
And 18 points. Pretty active.
Millard with a forceful rebound.
Good rebound. Nobody in the low post now, just spreading things out. Trying to get some back screens.
Under a minute to go in the first half.
You'd think they'd want to have Val Barnes put one up here from somewhere. Get him the ball. We're down to 14 seconds.
Lasper better look up at the shot clock, now at 10.
Here comes Barnes, following around, doesn't get the ball.
Winners will take it. Bosco blocked it. And Howard snares it.
Smart play by Howard. You know, realizing he's got time on the clock to get one last shot, doesn't force a bad pass. And there's that 1-2-2 zone. Iowa stayed in a good part of this half. How about Bosco down in the deep corner, Jim? Go inside and hit Bosco. He made his last one from the corner.
Under 10.
There he is.
He's got the shot from the corner.
Oh, Weber on a push.
And that's going to be his third.
Well, that was good execution by Michigan. They got Bosco the shot where he made the last one. And Chris Weber picks up a cheap foul with 4 seconds to go. The only good news about that for Chris Weber, he gets to take that mask off.
So now in the double bonus, they'll shoot two. Looking Bill will shoot two. Could give Iowa the lead at halftime. By the way, we see Iowa right now with 43 points. The most points scored on Michigan this entire season, Billy. Might surprise you.
Duke University.
Duke.
Yep.
79 points for Iowa, way ahead of that pace. The game is tied. Now with one more, looking Bill.
Jim, we haven't given this Michigan club enough credit for the way they've been playing this year. You know, last year, the outspoken, the brash. Fab Five. This year they're playing solid basketball.
Four and a half, King tried to go behind the back. We got a tie game at the half. Michigan scored the game's first 9 points, but Iowa comes back to tie it at the intermission. So at the end of the first half, the score, Michigan 44, Iowa 44. Pat O'Brien will be along with Prudential Securities at the half after this message and a word from your local station.
CBS Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four is sponsored by Busch Beer. Head for the mountains of Busch. Pepto-Bismol, the one that coats, is the only one you need. And by Extra Strength Denerec Shampoo with conditioners, the dandruff shampoo you can feel working.
On campus in Iowa City, the Hawkeyes tied with fifth-ranked Michigan 44 all at halftime. Jim Nansen, Billy Packer, and Billy, your thoughts on the first half?
Well, Jim, we talked about the emotion at the start of the game, and I thought that Iowa was up a little bit too high. They were down 9-0. Did an excellent job changing up their defenses and getting back in this, and of course, in a tie situation right now, and Michigan in a little bit of foul trouble, I think Iowa's got them kind of where they want them.
It's kind of interesting. Check out the shot selection in the first half for the Wolverines, Billy.
Yeah, you can see that everything that they're doing is on the left-hand side of the floor. That, of course, shows the shots that they have missed. Then when you throw in the shots that they have made, basically everything is still over on that side of the floor. Why? How about the fact that Jalen Rose, a left-handed player, moves down that side of the floor, and Iowa doing a good job keeping him on only one half of the court.
Well, Rose leads Michigan with 10 points. Val Barnes, 11 for Iowa. Halftime stats, Michigan scoring from the inside. You could tell that in the shot selection graphic.
They did a good job getting the ball right down from the front, down inside against that zone.
And the Wolverines manning the boards.
And that's surprising in a way, and the fact that Iowa has 17-plus rebounds over their opponents.
Iowa at the line, though, has made eight more than Michigan. And there are your top two scores. Rose and Barnes. Michigan has the basketball to start the second half. A Wolverine win that probably moved to number three in the polls. An Iowa victory will move into the top 10 with Seton Hall falling back this week.
Yeah, interesting. Bosco starting here in the second half. Maybe Steve Fisher likes the way he put up those jump shots. Made one, missed one.
Almost stolen by Winters.
Now there's a case where Winters started off all the way up at the top of the key in the 1-2-2 zone and works his way right back down to the baseline. Covers a lot of ground from that position in their zone defense. Pick up man-to-man out of bounds. Drop back into the zone. Most people do the opposite. Go zone out of bounds, then try to pick up man-to-man.
Under 10 on the shot clock. 5 on the shot clock. Weber just in time.
Good three-point shooter, Jim.
And he is their top three-point shooter.
Yes, sir. Excellent.
11 now for Weber.
That's 21 of 47 three-pointers on the year for Chris Weber. He doesn't mind putting them out there. He's an excellent shooter. Again, there's that double team from the weak side.
Barnes with a three of his own to tie it at 47.
Now Barnes right at a 40% three-point shooter, so obviously the two best on these two clubs. Here again, Rose using the left-hand side of the court.
Jimmy King, long rebound to Earl. Smith in the middle. Pull up jumper. He's hit a couple like that today.
Even though he made that, that was not a good idea.
Almost stole it.
Nobody was under the boards. Would have been a complete turnaround for Michigan. Got to wait on some people.
Howard, a lot of bodies around him. Barnes has it in the corner.
AC Earl looking for the lob.
Three-pointer. Long rebound right back to him. Looking, Bill. Good pass to Earl.
Nice team play by Iowa.
And the crowd is on its feet.
Another coaching point that Michigan said yesterday in practice, let the ball bounce around to get set up against the press.
A push outside, I think it's on Winters.
You pointed out, Jalen Rose had the big game last year against Iowa, hitting 34 against them. Now becoming more aggressive off the dribble.
Looking Bill sits. Winters, by the way, with his second personal foul. Howard. A.C. Earl with the outlet to Smith. On the wing to Barnes. Running one-handed.
You don't see many of those, Jim.
Rose. Oh, what a spin on that one.
Boy, Iowa really going up and down the floor against Michigan early in the second half.
Offensive against Smith, out of control.
Yep. This is a shot from the past, Jim. Barnes going right up there, shooting the old-time one-hander off the run. I didn't know that the modern college player had that shot in his arsenal.
Looked like Packer on that one.
Oh, no, wait a minute.
Riley back in, Jackson in. Remember, Jackson has three fouls.
I give you Oscar Robertson or somebody.
Okay.
Not, you know, come on, please, a real player. Bob Cousy. I mean, we go back into those days. Not. But you see so few of those. Everything today is you go all the way for the jam or you pull up for the jumper. Riley, a little push off there.
Should we see more of those running one-handers?
Yeah, I think it's. I certainly think it's a shot, particularly when you penetrate against zone defenses.
Rose, baseline to Jackson.
Jalen Rose is now starting to take over the game for Michigan. Really penetrating against his own, and Barnes likewise. Wide open. Wide open was Jackson. Yep.
Jackson, hey, he's looking good offensive-wise. Of course, the last two are lay-ins, but he now has 10 points off the bench.
That's just brilliant play by Jalen. He realized that Jackson had broken out and was open early. He didn't get the first pass. Hit him with a second one.
Webb.
Left hand.
The left hand, it spins out. Iowa basketball. Game is tied 53.
Jim, we talked about it in the first half. I don't think Iowa has done a good job today realizing on that double team on A.C. Earl where to get the ball to a good shooter.
Glasper, Montier Glasper back in.
Now, see, Webb is the man that would be open.
Outside, and Riley gets his fourth.
Now Steve Fisher can come back with Chris Webber, as he'll do right here. Riley not capable of going out and guard A.C. Earl when he puts the ball on the floor 20 feet away.
Dead ball under 16 minutes. They head to the bench with the game still tied, 53-all. It was tied at the half. You're looking at Chris Street's family, and we want to mention that they sent down to us a handwritten note, and I'll read it to you. The Street family would like to express their sincere thank you for all the people across Iowa and the country who have let them know how much everyone loved Chris. We will never forget your support. Signed, Mike Street and family.
Jim, a foul over the back. Kenyon Murray again being very active inside.
Juwan Howard with his second foul. Millard back in, takes the inbounds over Weber, who has the three personals.
Smart play by Chris Weber not to go ahead and try to chop down on Millard. He's strong and aggressive inside.
Jackson jumper. That was deflected by Murray.
And Murray takes off on the other end of the floor, wanting a fast break. Barnes got it right back. Excellent rebounding guard is Val Barnes.
Barnes with 18 now. Seven in this half, and Billy, he can get really hot in the second half. Look at the Ohio State game earlier this year.
Exactly.
Had 24 in the second half against the Buckeyes.
24 of his 27 points in the second half.
Oh, but this time he commits a silly foul.
He had 16 out of his 18 against Indiana in the second half, so we know how he can explode.
Only number one against Barnes. Third team foul. And A.C. Earl is coming in for Iowa.
Millard ready to go out. He's got to understand it right now. Hey, you're a player, son. You're not going to be in there for 5 seconds at a time. You're showing Coach Davis you belong on the floor.
He thought he was being replaced. It was right. Webb instead who sits. Jackson. That goes against Jackson. His fourth. Two Wolverines now.
Nice shot by Glassbar. Held his ground there, Jim.
Two Wolverines saddled with four. Jackson and Riley.
Nice dish, but out of control. Most of the time, when you go down on a fast break, 3-on-2, if you can keep the ball in the center instead of the wing, because the man in the center doesn't have that ability to go all the way to the hoop, because normally a defender is going to be right in his way, as Glassbar was.
Palinka, number three, in for Jackson.
Palinka's been silent today, coming off that 16-point game he had in his last outing. Only two.
Only taken one shot in this game. Double up on Earl. Gets it back to Millard. He lost control of it on the way up.
Again.
But Murray. Millard again.
Wow, he's got strong hands.
He ripped that rebound down.
I liked him yesterday in practice. And he's doing some stuff out here today. That one got away. Look at Kenyon Murray battle on the boards. They're possessed right here. That's some offensive rebounding.
Russ Millard shooting two.
Two shots for Millard.
That is faster. He's got nice looking form.
1 more for the freshman. Tips it. Murray almost got it. And Rose controls for Michigan. Michigan trailing by three.
Yeah, Jayden keeps his head up so he can see a full floor. That zone really active.
Rose, three-pointer. Millard with another rebound. His fourth rebound.
A.C. Earl would like a lob. They just don't look for him.
Barnes gets it to Millard. 58-53 Iowa.
I think it's time for a Michigan timeout, Jim. They have kind of lost their composure a little bit. They need to slow things down, get back into the game.
Against King, it's called.
Jim, they need a timeout badly here. You don't want this crowd to get into the game to the degree they are right now.
That's just the first on King. Looking Bill returns for Iowa. And Millard sits.
And now Steve Fisher's going to take one. I mean, Jim, you had to do this.
So the Wolverines call it. But the Hawkeyes lead by five over number five, Michigan. Jim Nance along with Billy Packer and Pat O'Brien from Carver Hawkeye Arena. Jackson and Riley with four fouls each on Michigan. And look at the offensive rebounds in this half, Billy. Iowa with eight to Michigan's zero.
Well, Steve Fisher talked about being out-rebounded by 22 in here last year. And Iowa was behind in rebounding in the first half, so they're making up for it here in the second half.
Montier Glasper.
There's the lap.
To Earl. Had to come down with it, but he gets it anyway.
AC Earl has been asking for the lob. Now, that's one of the problems. You call a timeout, it gives the opposing coach an opportunity to set up a set play. And I think what you have is Weber stepping out of bounds.
He did indeed. He stepped right on the line, right by the Hawkeye bench. This pass a little too steep for Earl to go right down in the cylinder with it. So he wisely came right back.
Well, Howard fake. Was there, but Howard didn't want to get in any further foul trouble. So AC Earl did the right thing.
7-point Iowa lead with the basketball. Trouble inbounding. AC Earl comes over to help out.
Jim, if you're Michigan, you just want to settle down a little bit in this game. They've let the pace of the game get away from them. They need to start thinking about who are their scorers and getting the ball in their hands. A lot of time in this game. See, Jalen's trying to do too much too fast.
3-on-2. Over to Barnes on a wing. And no foul. Yes, there is a foul call.
I thought so. I thought Jalen got him on the arm.
First on Rose in the 16th foul. By the way, next Saturday on CBS, college basketball, Florida State and UConn. That will be followed by third round coverage from Pebble Beach. The AT&T Pebble Beach National Pro-Am will follow Jack Lemmon. Can this be the year where he finally makes the cut?
Now, the year I want to see you walk down 18. Yeah, I want to see you in the Pro-Am. You know, my partner in real estate, Billy Satterfield, won the Pebble Beach Pro-Am one year. He and Lanny Watkins.
Yeah, I know Billy did. Was he a popular winner, too?
Yes, he was. He was back in our part of the country.
Absolutely.
His name is on the monument out there.
Right there behind the first tee at Pebble Beach.
Maybe I could know two guys that would win that Pro-Am, you and Billy. To get you in that.
I thought I was playing in it this year. Barnes will shoot one more. By the way, Billy, Val Barnes. You know how he came up with the name Val? You know how he was named Val?
Are you going to tell me it's backwards?
No. He was born on Valentine's Day.
Coming up soon. Very nice. I like that.
Long rebound to King. 8-point Iowa lead.
And they stay in that 1-2-2 zone.
Bosco from the corner.
That's why he's out there. And what happened there is he was so deep in the corner, Kenyon Murray's playing the top of that 1-2-2 zone, could not get all the way out there to stop it. Good one, Jim. You know what?
Yeah, he doesn't such handle himself like a freshman.
Right, he's such a smart ball player, doing well academically in school as well. He was a good student coming here, but he really knows how to play under control.
Now with 12 on the shot clock.
Now Smith, not a real good finisher here as a shooter. He's going to have to make a good pass. There it is.
Good one. Into Webb on the blocks. Webb shot. Back to a 7-point lead for Iowa. And a steal by Murray.
Oh, I'm going to call a foul on Bosco.
I'll tell you what, Murray took a pretty hard fall right in front of us. I think he hit his head against the table.
He sure did. He's getting up. You see, he goes right down. You know, he gets pushed out of bounds. Nice piece of officiating here. But there's Murray, who is so good at court coverage. And there's where he hit his head on the back.
He kind of bumped out on the foul on Bosco as he hit him with the rump.
Yep.
So that's the second on Bosco. And they're in the 1-1 now.
Now, Jim, they got to the two-shot foul in the first half. So the big difference in this game in the first half, as far as I was concerned, they went to the line 15 times and made 13, and Michigan only was 5-for-8. They're picking up where they left off.
1-1 for Murray. Freshman from Battle Creek, Michigan. He'll shoot one more. Billy, I'd heard that growing up, Kenyon Murray was a concert violinist. So I said yesterday, name your favorite all-time musician, anybody from the music world. Mozart, number one.
A.C.
Earl will come in for Webb. Smith goes out also as Millard's in the game. Bartles is in also. No, Smith is back in. So it's Bartles on the floor. 9-point lead for Iowa.
I thought Talley, who's now in the game, would have a big game here. Now, Michigan just is not getting into their offense at all. And I think they really need to slow some things down. Bosco got hit in the nose. He's down and out. He's knocked out, Jim.
Millard misses the shot.
Now that he... Back to the action, Jim.
11:33 remaining.
That does no good to run the sideline if you don't get somebody to help you.
Yeah, he was running the baseline, but Iowa had not scored.
No, now wait a second. You cannot run the baseline.
Because it was a foul, not
a
basket.
Right. That's right. Now, see, you can run after a made basket, but you cannot run on the end line if there was a turnover or a foul.
This should be Iowa's basketball.
Yep.
Michigan was getting the ball back after a foul against Russ Millard.
Please report to the Iowa training room.
Jim Burr came in from way back. And
I mean, Jim, maybe because all the time transpired, you're going to find the officials are going to say we didn't give the proper instruction to the man on the end line. But the only time you can run that end line is after a score. So what the officials are going to say because of all of the time that took place, and they asked both coaches to cooperate here, they're going to allow him to, he's going to have to throw from a standing spot. That's a nice piece of officiating and real good cooperation from the coaches. Because technically speaking, Howard had violated.
Howard finds King open. King underneath, bounce pass Weber. Puts it up backwards.
I thought Weber was in there a long time, Jim, certainly beyond 3 seconds. Well, Millard had taken a three there. Tom Davis should have really called it a day. Very patient. Working out of that box offense.
Oh, Millard missed the alley-oop. It was perfectly set up by Smith.
Tom Davis loved the execution of that play. It was a box. You'll see a box right here. Everybody thinking about what Iowa has been doing. And then you'll see the play was perfectly set up. The weak side, Millard coming in there, and he just tried to finish it off with too much power. ACO goes to the foul line.
Talley called on the foul. His second and number 8 against Michigan. So they're in a 1-1 Earl at the line.
You got to telestrate Millard's eyes. I mean, they're popping right out of his eddy so far.
So missing the front end.
Rose
now racing ahead to Rose. And four quick ones for Michigan to get back within 5.
That's why it's nice to be a 6'8" guard. Even with AC Earl on you, you can still score in a break.
Nice move by Winters.
Right around Jimmy King. Double teaming out of the press.
Rose.
Two shots in a row over AC Earl. One of the best shot blockers in college basketball, and Jalen puts it right over the top of him.
Oh, Earl got a little bit lost and threw it out of bounds. Let's get a report right now from Pat O'Brien. Pat.
All right, Jim, thank you. A couple of doctors, a couple of paramedics working on James Bosco. They are now saying he has a broken nose. He's still bleeding profusely, but he's sitting up. He's chatting. His mom and dad are at the game, and so they're back there in there with him. And another mask for Michigan. Back to you.
Exact injury that happened with Chris Webber in a practice injury. Hit with an elbow by Eric Riley. King and a foul. He'll shoot 2. Foul on Winters.
Jim, maybe. And this is a terrible thing to say in regard, you don't want to see somebody get hurt, but you know, Voskel's injury is what really slowed and took the Iowa game away, took the crowd out of the game. So a very valuable play on his part and certainly something he didn't want to do, but it has changed the complexion of this game somewhat. The crowd is still silent now.
Winters and Earl come out as Webb returns, along with Looking Bill. So King at the line. King with 5 points today. He'll shoot two.
Only a 60% free throw shooter is Jimmy King. And because of his slashing ability, he's the kind of guy should get on the line more than he does.
Looking Bill boxed out on Howard. Lead is four, Iowa 67-63.
Tom Davis says AC Earl sitting down, wanting him to have him rested for the stretch drive. Kenyon Murray, maybe the guy that has to score some for him here. He's been the one off the bench that's done it so far today.
Here he is, Murray. Smith.
Not a good shooter.
Way too strong.
Not a good shooter.
Weber. And one.
And that timeout by Steve Fisher a number of minutes ago, plus the injury to Vasco, has completely changed this game around. All the momentum has now shifted. Michigan got their composure back. They're not trying to make up for that deficit that they had in one play. And Chris Webber taking over inside.
Boy, Chris Webber will give you some reaction shots, won't he?
Yep.
Or should I say Macy Webber? He told the Michigan public relations, sports information staff, put me in the guide as Macy Webber out of respect to my father. His real name is Macy Edward Christopher Webber III. Says it's okay if we call him Chris. He has 15 points. Unable to make good on the free throw for the three-point play, but he has sliced the lead to two.
Tim, I think it's time to get Kenyon Murray the ball. He and Val Barnes out there, work it until one of those two can get off a decent shot. Two-man game going over on the one side. Back to the box offense now. There's Barnes.
With five on the shot clock, he took it.
That was a good play, though. When you get a good shot by one of your better players.
That ties it. King ties it on the slam. Webber with the assist.
I don't know how much longer AC Earl can sit down.
Barnes wants the lead back, and he gets it on the roll.
I say that AC Earl gets up. Here he comes.
Michigan scored the game's first nine. Iowa tied it at halftime. Then Iowa was in front by nine. Michigan's come back to tie it here in the second half.
Murray
blocks Webber.
Surprised Webber was going to take that shot.
Three-pointer by Rose. Long rebound to Murray.
They've done so well going down inside to Chris Webber. No reason to take a three.
Barnes. Howard, outlet to King. Here
three
comes
on
the
one.
Wolverines. 3-on-1 with King. Tied at 69.
Nice no call by the referee.
7:20 remaining.
You see, 11-4 since Bosco went down. Took the momentum out of the game. Excellent pump fake inside by Val Barnes, Jim.
Foul on King, his second. And we have some subs. Here's Earl. Glasper back in. Riley and Jackson, the two Wolverine players with three fouls, replace Webber and Talley.
Jim, some good things have happened in Iowa this week. You know, Eldon Miller won his 500th game.
Former Ohio State coach, now at Iowa.
The other thing was interesting. Iowa Essex Community High School did something in basketball history this week. It's never been done. Every point they scored in a game that they won was scored on a three-point shot. First time in the history of basketball. And you know, in Iowa, they still play women's basketball six on a side, three on each end of the floor.
Well, there's a timeout on the floor with 7:01 remaining, and the two free throws gives Iowa the two-point lead. CBS Sports coverage continues after this message and a word from your local station.
CBS Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four is sponsored by Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. McDonald's, what you want is what you get, guaranteed at McDonald's today. And by UPS, the package delivery company more companies count on.
This has been a terrific game from the start. Iowa leading 71-69, 7:01 remaining in the game.
Jim, arrested A.C. Earl back in the game. With 7:01 to go, you got to figure that Tom Davis can let him go the rest of the way now. Puts Val Barnes down so they can have him fresh going down the wire. I don't remember Jalen Rose ever being out of this game. Seems like he's played every minute.
This is the part of the game where Rose has so often taken over.
Well, he tried to do too much for a while there. Now he's back into a good sink.
Stolen by Lasker. Three on one. Bartles brings it out.
Well, they had a good three on one, but Glasper threw it behind Bartles.
2-point lead and the basketball.
Well, you can see Millard, Riley not even going to guard Millard when he steps outside. And that's why he's always open for the pass.
10 on the shot clock.
Here goes that double low stack again.
Freshman Glasper handling it. To Barlos. Oh, better put it up. He gets it away. Wow.
At the buzzer. Boy, was that cool, huh? Oh.
Crowd helped him out, too, Billy, with the countdown.
Nice hands by Jackson. Oh. Boy, that was some catch. Ball was thrown behind him, and he still was under control.
And really quick to the basket.
Yep.
Now with 12, Jackson.
Nice fake.
Earl traveled with it.
We'll see A.C. Earl down in the low post. The clock is working against him, but Jim, you made an excellent point there, and that is that the crowd counted down for A.C. Earl, gave him a lot of confidence to put that shot up just at the right time. Michigan much more composed than they were about 4 or 5 minutes ago.
Riley positioned underneath to tie it.
See, the reason that works is Jalen at 6'8 can throw right over the top of the zone. Kenyon Murray, he should put the shot up. That's the smart thing to do. Are they going to call it a jump?
They call it a tie-up situation. Yep. Iowa has the arrow.
But it was a smart thing to do. You double team, you're going to lose it. Just put up a bad shot and hope you get fouled.
Webb, Barnes, and Smith back in for Iowa.
Well, you'd have to figure they're going to go the rest of the stretch with this team.
5:01 remaining, tied at 73.
Riley now with Webb, not going to guard him. Webb's got to take up a little slack.
Almost lost it. Smith in the right place.
Tom Davis jumps up, sets up another offensive set. Boy, Murray's got some hands, doesn't he?
Three Iowa players really didn't help each other on that one.
How about Jackson behind the back under the other team's basket? Dangerous play.
This could give Michigan the lead. Down 9 in the second half. Michigan now with a 2-point lead.
Weber on the bench. Getting good play out of Riley. Nothing surprising there. Five.
No foul called, and that's off Michigan.
I thought Barnes was fouled on the shot.
And a whistle, a break in the action. We'll be selecting a Chevrolet player of the game from each team at the end of this one. Chevrolet donates a $1,000 scholarship to the general scholarship fund of each school. It'll be Iowa's basketball when we return with 3:59 remaining and the Wolverines by two. The horn to send the players back out. James Boskel returned to the huddle, to the bench for Michigan during that timeout. Wolverines used one earlier in this half, and Iowa has all three of its timeouts remaining.
Jim, that's a good news, bad news story. James, you broke your nose. That's the bad news. The good news is it may have helped us win the ball game.
Well, they were down 9 when he went out. They've outscored them 19-8 since the injury.
Michigan picks up tight. Really tight man-to-man. That's a tough shot in there.
Off Michigan. 21 on the shot clock.
Well, Webb really wanted the ball down low, but a very tough shot over both Riley, who's got the good wingspan, has played very well off the bench, and Howard. Go back to that double low.
Barnes for the tie. He is a pure shooter. 25 for Barnes. Game is tied.
Now, Winters, who plays the top of that key very well in this zone, better than does Kenyon Murray. He gets to the corners better.
Riley. Oh,
block! What a block!
And Iowa can take the lead. Smith.
I don't know why Smith wants to be so anxious to put a shot up, Jim.
Under 3 minutes.
And this should be Earl and Barnes show.
Rest Earl.
There you go. Uncoordinated, gangly, anything you want to say about a negative, but he gets the job done.
Stolen by Winters, right back. And Webb is hammered underneath. He'll go to the line for two.
Winters has great ability to feel in his defensive position, whether it's at the top of the key on that zone or whether it's in the press. Great anticipation on his part.
Juwan Howard called for his third. Call against Howard. Riley goes out.
It comes down to some free throw shooting, Jim. Something that Division I college basketball has really fallen off on. Lowest foul shooting so far this year from a percentage standpoint since 1958.
Two shots for Webb.
What ebb and flow in the last 6 or 7 minutes.
Michigan trailing by three with 2:28 to go.
See, watch all that ground that Winters covers in that zone defense.
Rose, a wild shot, but push while in the act of shooting.
And Winters came from all the way down on the low blocks to come out to the top of the key to try to guard Rose on that play. I thought he was in the act of shooting, didn't you?
Now they're saying it was before the shot. So
pretty close.
Fourth against Winters.
Those hands.
He snatches it, puts it right back, back to the rim.
Well, Howard kept it alive.
Boy, some bodies crashing, too.
They say the ball went over the top of the backboard. Touch last by Iowa. Boy, these referees have been excellent. Of course, we got three of the best in the business out here today. Very intense game, but they are all over it.
Murray back in for Winters. The officials, let's give them the credit. That's Tim Higgins, Ed Hightower, and Jim Burr.
I'm out.
three of the very best having an excellent game as a team.
Timeout called by the Wolverines. They're left with one. They trail by three with 2:11 to go. There's your game reset. Michigan on timeout. The next foul by Iowa will put the Wolverines into a 1-1, and the arrow belongs to Michigan. There have been 12 ties in this game and 15 lead changes.
Jim, I think if you're Michigan, you want to get the ball in Jalen Rose's hands, but not to shoot, to get the ball down inside to Weber and Howard. Go inside now.
He's looking
there
inside, and Earl reached around and has called for it, his third.
Good strategy there.
And this will mean a 1-1 for Weber.
And Jim, Iowa will be shooting two the rest of the way. I think it's the first time this year we've had a game where a team was in the two-shot foul situation in both the first and the second half. Not a strong point in Chris Weber's game, however. Only shooting 53% on the year.
0-for-1 today. Make it 0-for-2. And oh. Webb didn't come down strong enough with it. Michigan right back. Well, that's a tie-up, but the arrow belongs to Michigan.
You were right. Webb had an opportunity there on the missed free throw to pull it down. It would have been a big rebound for Iowa.
Millard.
And Webb's going to come out.
Russ Millard for J-Webb.
And even 2 minutes remaining. And that's going to be... That's an all-pro defensive back kind of a move. Two shots for Murray.
And this young man really worked on his free throw shooting yesterday. Great concentration. It's paying off for him now.
He certainly is. He's 6-for-6 from the line. Now to give Iowa the 5-point bulge. Now has scored more points against Michigan than any other team this season, breaking Duke's mark of 79.
Still want to go down inside. Let Weber touch it.
Rose in the lane. Weber gets it.
Oh, he is something. You get him the ball, his hands are so good, Jim. It just explodes inside. That brought even the Iowa fans off their seats.
And that kid is only 19 and the youngest of the Fab Five is Chris Weber. Foul called against Rose, his second.
I don't know if I've seen better hands in college basketball than Chris Weber has. I mean, he's so powerful, so quick. James Worthy had, at that stage in his life, those kind of hands around the basket. But other than that, there have been few and far between.
Sometimes when he gets it down there, you can't tell whether it's Karl Malone or Chris Weber.
Yeah, that's right.
One more for Barnes. He's 4-for-5 today from the line. As Talley comes in for Jackson. Michael Talley.
Now, what you have is Steve Fisher trying to free up Jalen Rose here, let Talley handle the ball, then give it to Jalen, let Jalen penetrate and go inside. Smart move by Steve Fisher.
Back to a 5-point lead, 1:19 remaining.
And look at Iowa doesn't press. I thought they'd press a little bit to occupy some time. See, here's what they're going to put the ball in Talley's hands and then let Rose penetrate.
Millard steps in front and makes the steal. And Weber commits the foul. Weber's fourth. Millard will shoot two.
Jimmy hadn't played many minutes, but it looks like he's been shooting a lot of free throws in his spare time because his form is excellent. Indiana moves out a little further in front in the Big Ten, it looks like.
That gives Iowa a 7-point lead.
Now Jalen Rose has got to put the ball on the floor and drive to the basket when he touches it.
Three-pointer by Weber. No. Earl underneath. And Earl will shoot two.
Jimmy King, number 24. His third.
The Big Ten came into the game today with four teams in the top 20. These two clubs obviously there, but when you look at this league, you got to be thinking six or seven deep, Jim, in the NCAA tournament, right?
I'd say that's about right on. I like the high in on that.
Yep.
52 seconds remaining.
Boy, they are putting the nails right in that coffin with these free throw shooting. Just excellent by Iowa.
This point, if he makes the free throw, will tie him on the all-time scoring list with Don Nelson for number 5 at Iowa. He is tied. And that is thrown away by Talley.
We pointed out Iowa, the best free throw shooting team in the Big Ten, now shooting over 70%. And they have really taken that to their advantage in this game.
Looking Bill in for Millard.
Kind of interesting. The assistant coach is really excited about Millard's performance today. They've worked with him all the time in a scout team.
Boy, that's the wrong guy to send to the line. Val Barnes led the Big Ten in free throw shooting last year. And he'll shoot two. Let's set the lineup tonight on CBS, a special edition of 60 Minutes. A salute to three remarkable women who have honored us with their presence on this broadcast. That's 60 Minutes tonight. And then it's Murder, She Wrote, followed by the CBS Sunday movie, The Shell Seekers.
You know, Jim, we keep talking about A.C. Earl, all Big Ten, but, you know, this Val Barnes starting to do some pretty exciting things in this league, coming off that big 29 points in overtime win against Michigan State.
27 today. You saw Juwan Howard. He's fouled out of this game. Iowa with a 9-point lead.
Flat on that one. You could give him a, excuse him for once, huh?
Oh, surprisingly, he misses them both.
Alley for three. That's Kenyon Murray again.
Barnes in there, too, to grab it.
You don't want to get fouled here.
He got hit in the head.
Yeah.
Get a chance to improve on that last free throw shooting effort.
Now, Jim, your best if you just give up the ball. Try not to get fouled. Let a little time go off the clock. And a smart play by A.C. Earl. You see where he was on that play? He stayed right under the basket to defend in case somebody made a steal. Instead of running down court. Pick number 55, the grad, thinking all the way. Ooh, three in a row.
He's 5 out of 9 for the day.
You can see Tom Davis takes everybody off the line, has him back down in defensive position. And with an 80-plus percent free throw shooter, you assume that he's not going to be a miss, but he misses four in a row.
Still time running out on the Wolverines. Open is Weber. Kenyon Murray.
Murray's got the great legs. So quick off the floor. But Tom Davis had some big wins at Lafayette, BC, Stanford, and here, but this one's got to be, considering everything that came into this game, one of the biggest of his career.
The Chevrolet players of the game are Ray Jackson from Michigan, 12 points off the bench, and Val Barnes from Iowa with 27. A check in the amount of $1,000 donated to each college's general scholarship fund.
There's five straight misses from the free throw line by two of the better free throw shooters that Iowa has. Six.
He had been seven for seven for the game prior to that. Rose with a three.
3 point basket.
And that three forces Michigan to call a timeout. The lead is six. So Rose rips a three, and Michigan has now used all of its timeouts. 86-80. Billy, some strategy.
Well, Jim, we go back to free throw shooting. We saw Indiana lose to Kentucky. Indiana lose to Kansas in their only two losses this year. This game could have been put away by Iowa. Not to say that they won't put it away anyway, but they've missed six straight free throws.
Get it up, wait. And Rose steals it. Oh, he had a foot on the line. Almost. Tough place to inbound from.
Yep, it really is.
Unless you're playing soccer.
Not a bad time to set a solid screen and go long.
Smith gets away from the pack.
And he wants to keep the ball moving. Don't get fouled.
Jim Bartles will go to the line.
But nobody came to Bartles to help him, so he didn't want to throw it away.
But only 10 seconds remaining. Michigan without any timeouts.
Right, they cannot stop the clock.
And Weber is fouled out. Weber and Howard both foul out of this game.
Jimmy Bartles will be at the line to shoot two.
Now, let's look at the AP top 10. Kansas lost earlier in the week. Indiana will be the new number one. Kentucky will slide up to two.
Right.
Carolina, of course, having lost yesterday by 26 to your Demon Deacons.
There's your Cincinnati, Jim.
Cincinnati. UNLV won last night at Utah State. Seton Hall will drop out of the top 10. Iowa will move in.
And J.R. Ryder, another big game. Certainly showed us last week that he moves up into any All-American contention that you might want to talk about.
Iowa, with the two free throw attempts coming up, will have shot 30 more from the line than Michigan. Michigan and 6 out of 12. Iowa currently 28 of 40.
See what Jalen Rose screamed out to the referee. How many is he shooting? How many is he shooting? As if like he really wanted to know. What he was trying to do was disconcert Bartles and have him lose some concentration. A little playground move there.
That Bartles is a good shooter. Help.
Don't foul now if you're...
He won't even... They won't even foul him now. Iowa has won at home. This was a game that the University of Iowa needed, and the state of Iowa had to have. So for Billy Packer and Pat O'Brien, I'm Jim Nance saying so long from Carver Hawkeye Arena, where the final score is Iowa 88, Michigan Iowa. They're celebrating with the Street family. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports, home of the NCAA Basketball Championship.
remember Chris's devotion to living life to its fullest. His competitiveness on the basketball floor and in the classroom, and his intense love for family and friends, with a moment of silence. Thank you.
The players out there that done it, and they deserve all the credit, and that's, I think, what you guys need to remember. And, as I'm on my little sermon here a little bit, we all got to remember these guys are 18, 21-year-old kids, and we're all too hard on them sometimes. And whatever they do from here on out, I know they're trying hard, and that's fine with me.